What's up, guys? Headphones Neil here, back with a quick addendum episode for the podcast. Just to share a quick review of a film that I learned about in my research for the Man with No Name trilogy. So, as it turns out, A Fistful of Dollars was a film that was based on an old Japanese film with essentially the same premise, character types, themes, and all of that, but developed as an Old West form, or developed in the U.S. in the form of a Old West movie. So the film that A Fistful of Dollars is based on is called Yojimbo. So that translates roughly to bodyguard. And it was it's an old Kurosawa film. So if you're not sure of who that name is or who that director is, he's the same guy who directed Hidden Fortress, which was partly the inspiration behind Star Wars. So that's as a side digression of who the director is, but essentially Yojimbo is a film that was released in Japan in 1961, good 3 years before A Fistful of Dollars, but essentially is the premise and base for A Fistful of Dollars. So rather than taking place in the American Old West, Yojimbo takes place in what looks like a form of feudal Japan. And you have essentially an unknown Ronin warrior coming into a town. The hotel or the barkeep saloon owner guy tells him he should leave, but the Ronin ends up wanting to stay. And he gets in the middle of a feud between two warring families in that town. Ultimately gets capped, or his trickery gets found out by one of the families. He gets around that and escapes while the families destroy each other. So if that's a lot of that sounds familiar, basically when you replace that with Old West themes, a unknown gunfighter comes into town and is gets in the middle of a feud between two families in the Old West. That's basically what A Fistful of Dollars became, to the point where A Fistful of Dollars, or the production behind it, got sued for essentially copying that premise. So if you want to have, or if you're interested in those kinds, or if you liked A Fistful of Dollars but prefer the Old West theme or want to see the origins of the film, then Yojimbo is definitely a film to watch. I thought it was particularly good just because the picture quality was so good. So I'm not sure if maybe the version was, you know, upscaled or upconverted for HBO Max, or they released a cleaner copy of it, but the quality of the film seemed a lot better than the quality for A Fistful of Dollars, to the point where I wanted A Fistful of Dollars to be upconverted to 4K if possible, or some form of 1080p where the quality is cleaner than it was. So I'm thinking that it's possible just the color or the film of the time or something along those lines wasn't as good as it was, or the film quality for black and white was just that much better where it looks that much cleaner. But I enjoyed the presentation of Yojimbo just to the point where it feels like it was like Mad Max Chrome Edition, where the color, or like there's a color version of Yojimbo, but they took it out and made it a black and white film. So it was really clean, it looked very good, so I think that also made it that much more enjoyable. But I definitely recommend watching the film if you've watched A Fistful of Dollars or any of the three films in the Man with No Name trilogy, and to just to go back and see the source and inspiration for the film, or those films, for the basically the American Old West version of the films, but set in a Japanese feudal period. So that's really all I gotta say for it. I mean, the Rotten Tomatoes rating by the critics is at 95% with an audience score of 96%, so very well rated, and I can't really say anything different from that. And it kind of, for me, in my mind, validates Westworld a little bit. I think it was either at the end of season one, but most likely in season two, where the writers had created a samurai world or shogun world, I forget exactly what it was called, to the point where it feels like they're drawing that inspiration, a parallel inspiration between, for example, season one being A Fistful of Dollars, and then season two introducing shogun world as a throwback to a film like Yojimbo. So it kind of actually makes me want to go back and rewatch the two seasons to see how they hold up now that I've seen these two films. So that's really all there was to say about that. So that's kind of why I wanted to release this addendum episode, just to say that Yojimbo, as of this recording of this podcast, is also streaming on HBO Max alongside the Man with No Name trilogy, so you can watch all of those and kind of see how good Fistful of Dollars kind of held true to the source material in Yojimbo. So that's all there is for this particular episode. So if you have any questions, comments, feedback of your own, or anything like that, then you can find me on Twitter at PatelN01. You can support the show in various ways and subscribe and all of that good stuff by visiting the website at headphonesneil.reviews. But that's all there is for this particular review. Thanks for tuning in, and until next time.